Hey everybody! Today I'm going to be setting up for April 2018 in my digital bullet journal. I talked about why I use a digital bullet journal in my last video on the subject, but the short answer is this. It works better for my workflow, it's faster for me, I get to use my graphic design skills, and I'm too finicky about how my bullet journal looks. If you've never created a digital bullet journal before, I will walk you through the process again today because I know this is pretty new for a lot of people. If you have any questions or if I don't cover anything thoroughly enough, feel free to leave them in the comments or visit me on Twitter or Instagram. I'm Leysketch at both of those and I check them pretty frequently. The footage happening right now in the background is me creating notebooks for the rest of the months of the year and adding personalized covers to each of them. I wanted to add some color to my bullet journal system since previously I had set it up as the past month had a gray cover and the current month had a purple cover, but I imagine that getting really dreary really fast. I decided instead to do a rainbow gradient across all the covers, with the reds in the summer months and the blues and purples in the winter months. Unlike all the other covers and spread templates for Noteshelf 2, your notebook covers have to be in your photos library. So I created them in Photoshop and I uploaded them to the iCloud as PNG files. I downloaded them to my photo library on my iPad so I could access them. Noteshelf, of course, has a ton of default covers you can use if you don't want to be super extra like me. You can set your covers when you're creating new notebooks, which is what I'm doing, or you can edit them afterwards. So, of course, after creating the covers for the notebooks, I wanted the first page within each notebook to be its own separate month cover page thing in the same theme. I uploaded all of those using Dropbox and then went through all the notebooks and changed them. Thanks to the power of having recorded everything, I know that both creating the notebooks for each month and changing their first pages only took about 5 to 6 minutes. It's really an intuitive program once you get used to it, which is part of the reason why I love Noteshelf 2 so much. Now, let's get to setting up April. This will be my fourth month of using a digital bullet journal system, and I honestly still really love it so far. It's so quick for me to just grab my iPad, fill her in, flip through to the page I need, change my spreads when I get bored, which happens way too often. That kind of stuff. I actually changed my bullet journal a ton after my last video for March, but you'll see those improved spreads today. I'm going to start off by adding all of my page templates to Noteshelf. To upload a page template, you need to actually be inside a notebook. You then click the gear icon to open up the menu. You'll want to go into Notebook Options, then Change Page Template. It will bring up the Change Paper screen. You can either use pre-installed papers, which you can see along the menu to the side, or you can access downloadable ones provided by Noteshelf 2, or you can go to Custom and upload your own. In the custom box, you'll see all my previously uploaded papers. Click the big gray box thing to upload your own. There are a few options here for where you can pull these files from, but I prefer to keep all of mine on my Dropbox. It's easy to upload, it's easy to access, they can all be organized in different folders. Click the file you want to install, it will download, and then you can rename it. Do that for all the files you want to add your custom papers for. So, Noteshelf 2 has updated since I last posted a video. It now has this handy favorites toolbar up top where you can save your favorite brushes for like the pens and highlighters and everything. It also does a thing where you swipe and hold before it adds a page. So that's cool. Maybe people had issues adding too many pages? I don't know. Maybe they just wanted to make it more obvious what was going on. When you make a new page in Noteshelf 2, the new page will have the same paper as the last page. In this case, my April cover page. But you just go into the gear icon again, and then you can go into change page template again, find your custom paper again. And so my first page is my monthly spread, which I color coordinated with the cover page. I wanted to add some cute flowers or something, but I couldn't find any I liked, so it's pretty plain. I left room for the new favorites toolbar and decided to add Easter, since I do work in the service industry and Easter is kind of a big deal. On my monthly spread, I tend to put anything I want to look forward for, so when I'm going to be uploading videos, and I'll put in which video is scheduled for when, but I didn't do that here since spoilers. I'll also put in appointments, that sort of thing. My next spread is Art Momentum. So it's this kind of thing my friends and I created a couple years ago as a way to get us to create every day. I don't want to say the only way to improve at art is to draw every day, but you'll definitely remain looser and find it easier to get back into drawing if you do it every day. There'll be less of a warm-up period, at least for me. I used the highlighter tool to fill in the Wii calendar, and the legend below is filled in with colors in a slightly smaller size. So for each day I accomplish something, there's a dot to fill in. The highlighter is pretty rad in Noteshelf in that it is transparent over the text below, and I'll fill in the first week so you get an idea of that. At the bottom is a list of things I want to draw, which I would fill in with the text tool. So if I want to draw, say, Psylocke from the X-Men, that would be filled in here. I have a to-do list related to anything art-related, say if I have a piece I want to finish for a certain day, and then I have art goals and where to improve. Art goals would be something like learning how to draw perspective and create backgrounds. It's something I haven't done before that I want to learn how to do. Where to improve would be something like anatomy. Yeah, I know how a human body looks, but you can always improve how you draw it and study it more. The next spread is no spend. In the winter, I don't get as many hours, so I don't have as much of an income. No spend is set up pretty similarly to the Art Momentum page, where I have some boxes to fill in. I use the highlighter with a color code legend to mark when I have and haven't spent money. It's all pretty self-explanatory, I think. The weekly spread is probably the most straightforward of them all. I've played with my weekly spread a lot over the past couple months, and I'm going to try this more simplistic approach for April. Like with all my weekly spreads, I fill in the date range and then fill in the little boxes next to the days of the week with what the actual date is. Since April is themed around green, I'm using a green pen instead of purple, which is my favorite color, if you don't know that. Oh, Noteshelf 2 also recently added a sharper pen, so that's really nice. That's what I'm using here. Have you ever tried a digital bullet journal? Have you ever tried a bullet journal in general? Let me know down below in the comments. I would love to hear from you. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. It really helps combat that YouTube algorithm. Also, if you enjoyed hanging out with me and want to see future videos about art stuff and bullet journaling, please subscribe. That's it for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!